Hi guys, it's Joanna here. Let's talk about our bodies. So without any judgment, I want you to look into the mirror. What do you see? Do you see long, slim limbs, wide hips, and perhaps more fat accumulation around the belly area, or a more sporty, muscular body? We know just how complex our body types can be, but knowing where you fit in could help determine the best exercise and diet plan for you. So in this video, we want to find out your dominant body type and understand the exercises and diet that works best for your body and help you form more realistic goals. What is your body type? We are all created different, but just as beautiful. Typically, there are three dominant body types: ectomorph, mesomorph, and endomorph. Your genetics predispose you towards one of the three body types, and you can't change that. However, with dedication to your training and also eating right, you can get closer to another body type. But do understand that your daily exercise, diet habits, lifestyle, and even metabolic changes through pregnancy or menopause can skew your body type. So if you are uncertain where you fit in, just think about how you look like in your late teens or early 20s. So let's take a look at the three dominant body types. Ectomorphs. Simply put, these are people who seem to eat whatever they want and never gain any weight because they have a fast and high metabolism. They are usually thin and lanky. They have smaller bone structure with shoulders that tend to be narrower than their hips. Just think of the endurance athletes or your typical model. Typically, your goal is to gain weight. Second, mesomorphs. You have a medium bone structure and an athletic body. You are considered to have the good gene because you have an efficient metabolism, which means it is easier for you to gain muscle or even to lose fat. If you keep to an active and healthy lifestyle, it is relatively easy for you to maintain your weight. Yes, you can gain weight, but once you get back into eating well and exercising, the excess weight comes off pretty easily too. Typically, your goal is to lean up. Finally, endomorphs. You have a soft, rounder body. You have a stockier bone structure with a larger midsection and hips. You find that you gain fat so easily just by eating a small chocolate bar, but you struggle to lose weight. Your metabolism is naturally slower, hence you have to pay more attention to what you eat in order to get fit. And typically, your goal is to lose weight. These are the three dominant body types. You may find that you don't fit perfectly into one category, but a mixture of two body types. Hence, you may be an ectomesomorph. This body type is lean and muscular. Or mesa-endomorph, you are strong, but the muscles aren't well defined, like a rugby player. Or endomesomorph, the skinny fat people who is naturally thin, but gain weight due to lack of exercise and a poor diet. So what is your body type? Let me know in the comments below. Once you've figured out which body type you fall into, let's further understand the types of exercises and diet that fits your goals and needs. Let's start with ectomorphs. Since your goal is to gain weight and lean muscle mass, we want to focus on resistance training and limit cardio or endurance type training. Your training should be focused on strength and hypertrophy, which is to build muscle. In order to gain strength and size, you want to be lifting heavy. The weights should be heavy enough for you to only be lifting between 6 to 10 reps, with longer rest times, 1 to 2 minutes between sets, and go for 3 to 4 sets. Follow a simple routine with heavy compound movements and minimal isolation movements per muscle group. Compound movements are basically exercises that work several muscles or muscle groups at once. Because compound movements recruit a large number of muscle fibers, it is the most effective way to build muscle mass and quickest to increase overall strength. Some of the workouts include squats, lunges, bench press, push-ups, deadlift, and pull-ups. Aim to strength train at least 3 to 4 times weekly on every alternate days. Go for short cardio sessions, between 10 to 20 minutes twice weekly. You can treat it as your warm-up to avoid burning too much calories or muscle mass, but it is still important to improve your stamina and heart health. When it comes to your diet, you should eat a mass gain-focused diet because your body tends to burn off energy really fast compared to other body types. Your calorie intake should be 700 to 1,000 calories more than what your body needs to maintain your current body weight. The low-carb fat loss diets are not for you. Aim for higher carb, moderate protein, and low fat. So go for 50% carbs, 30% protein, and 20% fat. Here's an example of what your portion should look like. Since your metabolic rate is very high, you need to keep fueling your engine. So try to eat more frequently, every 2 to 4 hours. And for some who are extremely thin, incorporating mass gainer nutritional shakes into your diet can help as well, because they are very high in calories. So if you aren't sure how to calculate your BMR, TDEE, macros, or even how much you should eat, then do watch my video on how to calculate food portions and macros. All the links will be in my description box below. Mesomorphs. Well, count yourself lucky because you are naturally strong and respond quickly to exercise, making it easier for you to gain mass, lose weight, and stay lean. For this reason, you want to aim on a wide performance spectrum, focusing on strength, size, and endurance. You can dedicate a block of exercise to strength, a block to hypertrophy, and a block to endurance training. Mix it up and avoid focusing only on one type of training, because you will lose muscle mass if you are too focused on endurance conditioning. And you can gain excess fat if you only perform heavy resistance training. So for example, incorporate moderate to heavy strength training 3 to 4 times weekly, and mix it up with HIIT workouts as your cardio 2 to 3 times weekly. Typically, your goal is to lean up. You want to maintain your body weight, but to lose fat and increase muscle tone. Mesomorphs fall somewhere in the middle. So your macros should be split pretty evenly between carbs, protein, and fats. So go for 35% of carbs, 35% of protein, and about 30% of fats. Here's an example of your food portion. Your food intake can also be adjusted according to your training days. For instance, reduce on carb and increase on protein on strength and conditioning days. Whereas on HIIT workout days, you can increase your carb intake post-workout to fuel your body. As for your total calorie intake, you want to eat enough to maintain your current body weight. But if your goal is to lose a little bit of weight, then consume slightly less. As an endomorph, you may feel like you are destined to be overweight. If you are thinking that right now, this is absolutely not true. You can change your body by changing your lifestyle. If your metabolism is sluggish, you need to eat the right food to fire up your metabolism. If you lead a sedentary lifestyle, get moving and incorporate exercising as part of your daily routine. You need to do what's right for your body and not blame it on genetics. When it comes to exercising, resistance training is still key, but adding more endurance training will help to increase your metabolic rate and shed fat. A higher muscle mass will increase your BMR, hence making your body more efficient in burning fat. Go for 3 to 4 days of strength training. Your aim is to complete more work in less time. That means shorter rest periods, because we want to keep your heart rate elevated throughout the majority of a session. And go for moderate weights, where you can perform between 8 to 15 reps per set, and only rest between 30 to 60 seconds. Incorporate compound movements, because it helps you to burn more calories. Interval and circuit trainings are also very effective, which is what most of my workout videos are based upon. You should also know that your muscles are strong, especially your lower body, so you can really lift. Powerlifters or rugby players are often classified as endomorphs. As for the remaining days, go for endurance training. It can be 2 days of lower intensity conditioning for 30 to 60 minutes, such as inclined walk, light jog, biking, hiking, or swimming. And once a week, do a HIIT workout. Don't forget to also dedicate 1 day a week for rest and recovery. What's even more important is your diet. You tend to be more insulin resistant and have a lower carbohydrate tolerance. Hence, you should limit your carb intake. You do better on higher protein and fat with lower carbs. So go for 20% carbs, 45% protein, and 35% fat. Hence, that is why most overweight people do well on a keto diet. Because your body do not tolerate carbs very well, the best method is to avoid high carb or starchy carb foods outside of the workout window. So only consume starchy foods such as rice, whole grain breads, quinoa, barley, yams, or potatoes after exercising. That means outside of your workout window, your diet should consist of protein, healthy fats, and vegetables. So here's an example of your meal. Now, in order to lose weight, your total daily calorie intake should be at least 500 to 700 calories less than your total daily calorie expenditure. But you still need enough calories to maintain a healthy lifestyle. Do not undereat, because that will only cause damage to your metabolism, workout performance, and will only hinder your weight loss. So again, what's your body type and what are your goals? Let me know in the comments below. Remember, there is no one simple solution to achieving your health and fitness goal. If you have been eating well and exercising, but you're not getting the results you're looking for, then perhaps you're not doing it correctly according to your body type. You have to keep trying different methods and see how your body responds and keep tweaking and progressing through the journey. And there is no shortcuts. It's all about being consistent with your workouts, eating a clean and well-balanced diet, managing your stress levels, and just trusting the process. It is not an overnight transformation, not even a few weeks. It will take months and even years. Hence, I always believe that fitness is for life. There's no deadline to it. If you enjoy this video and if you find this video to be useful, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it on to your friends and family members, and do subscribe to my YouTube channel, okay? I have a lot more fitness tips, nutritional tips, workout videos, as well as healthy recipes. And let me know what topics would you like to hear more of in the comments below. I'll see you next time. All the best.